In this video we will isolate benzoyl peroxide from acne treatment and Akneroxid tint cream. Product contains carbomer 940, which is polyvinyl polymer insoluble in acetone and in basic solutions. It is used as gelling agent. Next we have lauromakrogol 200, that is essentially polyethylene glycol, which is soluble in water. Ethylenediaminetetraacetic acid or EDTA is soluble in water. Sodium hyrdoxide is used as stabilizer. Product contains water, that increases polarity of our solvents, so we have to use a lot to dissolve benzoyl peroxide. We start by adding 150 milliliters of acetone into disposable plastic cup to dissolve BP from product. Next, add contents of the cream to the acetone. Stir the solution and try to break the cream into smaller chunks. Acetone solution turns white due to water content. You can see crystals of BP possibly contaminated with EDTA on the stir rod. Then we filter the solution through cotton pads as coffee filter was clogged very quickly. In the filter you can see chunk of carbomer turned into a latex-like blob along with some crystalline powder which is benzoyl peroxide that participated out. We wash this with acetone until all crystals dissolve. We are left with 250 milliliters of filtrate. This is big waste of solvent, so pre-drying cream may be a good option. We add water to our filtrate to participate BP out of the solution. May more water. Actually in the end of process we added about 3 liters of water. That was kinda overkill, but about 1 liter was really necessary to achieve a good yield. Here you can see the participate. And after some cooling. Now we filter the participate. The water you see after filtration was actually a lot cleaner as it looks. Beaker and contents left in filter was washed with about 100 milliliters of water. You can see that we are left with white fluffy powder. Powder was dried as much as possible, but not completely, and transferred to Petri's dish. Still fairly wet product was rated, and I guess there are about 4 grams of benzoyl peroxide, which is 80% yield based on starting material. That is very good. However, that is only a guess. To test our product we can test explosive thermal decomposition. Product was heated indirectly with propane torch. When suddenly small explosions occur. Not very big though. Benzoyl peroxide can be used as polymerisation photoinitiator. Upon irradiation decomposes to benzoic acid and oxygen. Store the product wet or dry below 4 degrees Celsius.